Hi and welcome to the session. Let's work out the following question. The question says the line segment joining the points 3, minus 4 and 1, 2 is trisected at the points P and Q. If the coordinates of P and Q are P2 and 5 by 3 Q respectively, find the values of P and Q. Let us start with a solution to this question. So let the coordinate of point A be 3, minus 4. B 1, 2, P is given to be small p 2 and Q 5 by 3 Q. So this is the line we have. A, P, Q and B are the points on this line. Since P and Q are given to be trisecting AB, therefore we have AP is equal to PQ is equal to QB is equal to 1 by 3 AB. Or we have AP is equal to 1 by 3 AB. This we call 1. And we have BQ is equal to 1 by 3 AB. We call this 2. But by the distance formula, we say that AB is the distance between the point A and B, and that is equal to square root of 1 minus 3 the whole square plus 2 minus minus 4 the whole square, that is equal to square root of minus 2 the whole square plus 2 plus 4 the whole square. That is equal to square root of, now square of minus 2 is 4 plus square of 6 is 36. That is equal to square root of 40. Now AP, that is distance between the point A and P, will be equal to square root of P minus 3 the whole square plus minus 2 minus minus 4 the whole square. That is equal to square root of P minus 3 the whole square plus minus 2 plus 4 the whole square. That is equal to square root of P minus 3 the whole square plus 2 square. That is equal to square root of P minus 3 the whole square plus 4. Or we can say that AP is equal to square root of P minus 3 the whole square plus 4. And similarly, BQ is equal to square root of 5 by 3 minus 1 the whole square plus Q minus 2 the whole square. That is equal to square root of 5 minus 3 divided by 3 the whole square plus Q minus 2 the whole square. This is equal to square root of 2 by 3 the whole square plus Q minus 2 the whole square. And that is equal to square root of 4 by 9 plus Q minus 2 the whole square. Now putting the values of AB, AP and QB in 1 and 2, that is this equation and this equation, we get square root of P minus 3 the whole square plus 4 is equal to 1 by 3 into square root of 40. On squaring both the sides, we get P minus 3 the whole square plus 4 is equal to 1 by 9 into 40. Or we can say that P minus 3 the whole square is equal to 40 divided by 9 minus 4. Now, this implies that P minus 3 the whole square is equal to 40 minus 36 divided by 9. This further implies that P minus 3 the whole square is equal to 4 divided by 9. Or we can say that P minus 3 is equal to plus minus square root of 4 by 9. That is equal to plus minus 2 by 3. Now we have either P is equal to 2 by 3 plus 3 or P is equal to minus 2 by 3 plus 3. Now this will imply that P is equal to 2 plus 9 divided by 3, and this implies that P is equal to minus 2 plus 9 the whole divided by 3. Now from this one we have P is equal to 11 by 3, and from here we have P is equal to 7 by 3. Therefore P is equal to 11 by 3 or 7 by 3. Also, we have square root of 4 by 9 plus q minus 2 the whole square is equal to 1 by 3 into square root of 40. Now, squaring both the sides, we get 4 by 9 plus q minus 2 the whole square is equal to 40 divided by 9. Now, this further implies that q minus 2 the whole square is equal to 40 by 9 minus 4 by 9. That is equal to 36 divided by 9. Now, taking square root on both the sides, we get q minus 2 is equal to plus minus square root of 36 by 9. That is equal to plus minus. Now, 36 is the square of 6 and 9 is square of 3. So, we have plus minus 6 by 3. And this further simplifies to plus minus 2. Now we have q is equal to 2 plus 2 or q is equal to minus 2 plus 2. Now in this case we have q is equal to 4 or we have q is equal to 0. Therefore our answer to this question is p is equal to 11 by 3 or 7 by 3 and q is equal to 4 or 0. So this is our answer to this question. I hope that you understood the solution and enjoyed the session. Have a good day.